So initially we have seen this program which will represent you the execution of form, right? So we had created this using form tag, and in form tag you have seen that there are different elements, right? So what are those different elements, guys? Different elements like text box, check box, button, radio button, right? I also told you like we can have a text area. So there are different areas, or you can say there are different elements when it comes to what? The form, right? And when we executed this code after entering certain name or USN or choosing your gender, entering or choosing your hobbies, okay? So after choosing your hobbies, we had this box. So that box is nothing but what, guys? It is a box which will represent the list. So this is called as a list box, isn't it? So these are called as check boxes, these are called as radio buttons, and these are the labels, and this is the text box, right? And these are the buttons, submit button and reset button. So what happens with the form here? So I told you that this type of forms are nothing but what? Static. Okay, this type of forms are nothing but what? Static. So what is meaning of static, students? Static means what? Whatever data you are entering, same is displayed as an output into the browser. You are not going to get any responses from the entered data. You are not going to store the data. You are not going to calculate anything. Okay, you are not going to use any logic in this. So static is a bit related to what? Design part, you can say. So whatever you type in your HTML code, that will come on the screen as it is. So here no more logic is used. Logic in the sense entering two numbers or adding the two numbers, calculating the even and odd numbers, checking whether the entered data is what, valid or not, checking whether the entered digits are alphabets or numbers or not. So all this is nothing but what? It all comes under the dynamic pages. Are you getting? All such things will come under what? Dynamic pages. So there are two different web pages. One is a static and another is dynamic. So whatever HTML code you are going to write, all it is included as a part of a what? Static pages. So for dynamic, for making these pages so dynamic, okay, we need what? Server side programming languages. So HTML is what, students? HTML is a client side programming language. Client side means what? Where you are making the designings, okay, where you are going to design. That is why HTML is a static programming language. Whatever you type, that is displayed on the screen. So for example, dynamic, as I told you, adding of a numbers, performing calculations, okay, performing different types of calculations, requesting and responding with the data, playing with the data, that you make a request. For example, you have a Gmail, right? So what happens in Gmail account? You enter your user ID and you enter your password, and after that it goes to the Gmail server, and then it is validated in the sense it is going to check whether what data you have entered, that is valid or not. So after validating, what it will do, if it is valid, it will send you back the response and you will enter into your Gmail box, isn't it? You will enter into your Gmail box or Gmail space. It is also called as a Gmail workspace, where you are going to open your Gmail space. So this all comes with the dynamic thing, students, okay? It is not possible with static web pages. So as you had already learned HTML, you have already learned CSS, you know what are the different tags, what are the different attributes of these tags, what are the different ways of writing the CSS. We also know what are the different properties of CSS. So all this acts as a what? Static part. HTML and CSS are required only for the designing part. Okay, but when we want to store the data, when we want to retrieve the data, when we want to modify the data, okay, so all these comes with what, students? Everything will come with the dynamic pages. Okay, everything will come with the dynamic web pages, isn't it? Okay, so to make some calculations, okay, along with that, what is important concept, students? So we have to always enter the valid data. Okay, we cannot enter the data by your own choice. So suppose I ask you to enter what phone number. Okay, what type of data is expected here? Digital. Okay, what type of data is expected? Digital. Can you enter alphabets for phone number? No. We have to enter what? Digital data when it comes to the phone number, isn't it? So, and what is the another validation with the phone number, students? You can have maximum 9 to 12 digits, maximum some other state digits. I will consider it as a 9. Okay, 10 to 11 to 12 within this. Okay, not less than 9, not more than 11 or 12. So this is called as validation. So when you want to enter the data, you have to perform validation and check whether the data you are entering that is correct or not. Isn't it? Only designing is not a part of a website. You have to go for validations, calculations, retrieving the data, performing, taking the requests and responding back. All this comes under what? The dynamic web pages. Okay. And it is also considered under what? Validation. Suppose if I ask you to enter name, how will you enter the name? How will you enter the name? For example, SNEHANAGAONKAR. This is my complete name, students, right? So this is called as a first name. Okay. Sneha is a first name. A is a second, which is middle name. And Nagaukar, which is the last name, that is also called as a last name. So name itself consists of first name, middle name, and last name. Are you getting that? So when user want to enter his name, you have to give him a valid box saying enter first name, enter middle name, enter last name. Or you can also keep it simple saying enter your name. So this is a validation when it comes to the name. What is another validation when it comes to name, students? It should be alpha, isn't it? Is your name like this one, Sneha 1, Sneha 2, Sneha 3, in this way, does the name comes? No. Are you getting? For example, Sanjana 1, 2, 3, Sanjaya 1, 2, 3. Like, did you get like this? Can you get the numbers like this? No. Isn't it? So always your names are what, guys? Alphabets. You have to always consider what? Alphabets. Isn't it? That is the validation for your name. Are you getting? Okay. So this is all called as what? Validation. Entering valid data. Choosing valid data. Performing proper verifications with the data, right? It is called as a validation. Another, let us take your USN number, students. What is your USN number? Suppose I have EM12100, right? So USN is what, students? Alphanumeric. USN is what? Alphanumeric. What is alphanumeric? Alphabet plus numeric. Did you get that? So in this way, first you have to analyze what data you are going to enter into your forms. Another important concept of our programming is form. We have to create a form when we want to request for the data and when we want to respond for the data. Request means what? When you just open the Gmail box, you enter your username and password, that becomes a request. When it is validated and the response comes back to you, it is a response. Are you getting? So for all these things, okay, for all these things, we need a concept of what? Client side, okay, middleware, right? So we need a middleware softwares, okay? Yeah, we need a middleware, and then we need a server side. Are you getting? So we need these three tier architecture. We need these three concepts when we want to develop our web pages, okay? When we want to design our web pages, students, we need all these concepts. We need what? Client, we need middleware, we also need a server. So what you are learning as a part of HTML, CSS, okay? All these comes under what? Client, okay? All this is under a client programming where you are making the designing, okay? Where you are making the designing. Now, when you want to make validation, there comes your JS or our JavaScript. When we want to perform the validation, okay? When we want to perform validations with our data, there comes what? Your JavaScript. So JavaScript acts as what here, students? It acts as a middleware. It takes your data. It just validates. Middleware only for validation, students. Okay, middleware only for validation. We can also use .NET. Okay, we can also use some other softwares which also processes your data. Like we can also use JSP. Okay, ASP, all these are different web programming languages. Now, when it comes to server, Okay, so we need to store this data into the server. So that is called as a database, where you want to store the data and where you want to take the data. For example, I will give you very common example, students. So suppose what your mother is doing every month, she is ordering for the ration, right? She is ordering for the ration at the home. So every time she demands 10 kg of rice is required. So your father, what he will do? He will go to the store, he will collect the rice. So your father acts as what? Your front wear. He goes and takes the rice. Okay. The middle person is your shopkeeper. The shopkeeper will give you the rice. Right. So he's a middleware. He is taking your request. And then your father will come back to home and he will hand over it to the mother and she will place it into the tin or she will place it into the jar safely. Right. So that she can take the rice from that whenever needed. So our rice box or a rice jar is just like a database server here. So she is going to extract in that. She is going to keep in that. We are going to use from that. So that is our container. So whatever designing you are going to make, whatever data you are going to add, that will go to the middleware. From middleware, it will go to the database. Okay. From database, again, it will come to the web browser. So web browser acts as what? The media for execution, for sending the request as well as for the responses. So in web browsers only, we fill the designs. We also see the output in the web browser only, students. Okay. All right. So depending on this information, okay, depending on this information, we got to know that, okay, we got to know that whenever we want to do validations of your data, whenever we want to do validation of our data, we need something called as what? JavaScript, okay, to validate the data. So whatever data is entered, to check whether that data entered is correct or not, to check whether the data, whatever you are entering, is valid to go into server or not, or before sending to the server, you have to process the data. So all this work is done by the JavaScript, students. Okay. So in the JavaScript, it is not exactly considered as a designing. JavaScript is considered as an object-oriented programming. It is a concept of what? Object-oriented programming. Just like your C programming, which is procedure-oriented. So JavaScript is extracted from Java language. Okay. So for JavaScript students, we there's no need to learn Java programming here. I am going to explain you in a very simple way. So JavaScript itself is one subject. JavaScript itself is one programming language, scripting language. It is exactly not a programming language. It is called as a scripting language. Why it is called a scripting language, do you know? Because we are going to add this. Where? Into the HTML code. You're going to add that in the HTML code into the script tag. Okay? We are going to include the script. What is meaning of script? Suppose you are performing in a drama and the director will give you a script. So what is that script? You have to read and practice for that script and perform only that much, isn't it? If you are the enemy, if you are a dushman in the movie and you are reading the script of a hero, what they will do? They will remove you, right? They will fire you from the movie and they will say that, no, you are a villain and why you are reading the script of a hero? They will say like this, right? So scripts are something like what is given to you, only that much has to be performed, right? So that is why there is one tag called as a script tag, okay? So script tag is used when we want to do such kind of validations. When we want to do such kind of validations, what we do, students? We use a script tag, okay? So by using the script tag, what you are going to do, you are going to write this JavaScript language. Okay, you are going to write the JavaScript just like CSS. How we write CSS? We write CSS in three different ways, right? We also write that in HTML, head tag and style tag. Similarly, we also write JavaScript within the HTML also. We can write separately also. There are 3 to 4 ways of writing JS. Okay, just like there are 3 different ways of CS. And different forms of CSS, right? Similarly, JavaScript can also be written in different ways, and there are different methods also of writing the JavaScript. But let us initially understand that basically JavaScript is included into the script tag. Okay, let us understand that JavaScript is by default included where, students? Into the script tag. Okay, so within the script tag, what you are going to write, you are going to include the code of your JavaScript. So I prefer calling JavaScript as JS also, students. Okay, so the shortcut name which I prefer for JavaScript is JS. Okay, so when you add another word for JS such as JSP, it becomes Java Server Pages. Okay, when I say P, JSP means Java Server Pages. When I keep it as a JS, it means JavaScript. When I write it as CSS, it means CS. When I write it as HTML for HTML, it is an HTML. Okay, we know all this, right? HTML means HTML. XML means, it is another language, the last unit of your syllabus, XML. Okay, we have another language, ASP, that is Active Server Pages. We have ASP.NET. But right now we are going to learn only JavaScript and we are going to learn XML for your syllabus. So once when you move to the next sem, you will learn all the different subject students. Right now, we are totally focusing on the basics of your web programming. We are focusing on the designing. We are focusing on the validation. And we are going to focus on the middle part. Okay, how to work with the middleware of your data. How to process your request. What should happen with your request when before going to the your server. All right, so we are focusing on that. Is it clear? So JavaScript is object-oriented programming language. It falls under OOP concept, object-oriented programming language. Okay. And what happens to JS? JS is always included within the script tag. It is a scripting language. It falls under a dynamic language. Okay. It falls under dynamic programming language. So dynamic means you got to know now what is dynamic. Adding validations, performing some calculations, okay, adding some logic. It is an interactive language. All these are the features of JS students. All these are the features of JavaScript. It is interactive programming language. It is an interactive scripting language. Why interactive? You have to enter the data. It will calculate the calculations and it will respond you back. Okay. For example, take an example of your messaging applications, for example, WhatsApp. You are typing a message, your friend, it will show that the message sent, received, read. These three are the acknowledgements that you receive from the WhatsApp applications, isn't it? That is called as an interactive. Okay. So through scripting language, we are going to develop such interactive dynamic web pages. All right. Okay, students. All right. Now see, so let us come back to this example of the form. We have already seen this example of the form, right? Now suppose if I enter a name here, initially we did that, right? So yes, some USN I'm going to enter, okay? I will choose, for example, female, and I will choose everything, that is I like reading, I like singing, then all like I like all the subjects, suppose I take it as an English, right? Now, suppose I enter name as SS. Name, I told you, it cannot be number. I have to enter alphabet only. Suppose if I enter something like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, okay? And suppose USN, okay? USN, what I will do? I will enter some symbols. So, which is not valid, no, students? What is valid? I told you, what is the valid form? For name, you have to take only alphabets. For USN, you cannot take symbols. You can only take what, students? You can only take alphabets and numbers when it comes to USN. If I take name, it has to compulsorily take what? Alphabets. Are you getting that? Now, after filling this data, this is my data now. This is the name and this is the USN. After filling this data, what I do? I click on the submit button. Please observe, all of you. You have to observe, click carefully. After filling this raw data, why raw? The first time data which is not processed is called as a raw data. Okay, after entering this raw data, what I'm going to do? I'm going to click on the submit button. So what should happen to my data when I click on the submit button? What should happen? Tell me, students. You tell me what should happen. All of you, please enter your details into the chat box. Still there are 9 minutes. Enter your attendance into chat box, all of you. Those who have not yet entered, please enter your details. Okay. Yes. Coming back to the code, what is expected if I enter name and if I enter USN? Okay. and if I click on submit, whether it should take this data or it should like show me an error. Tell me, students, it should take this data or it should show me an error. Yes, whether it should take this data?
It's a error, ma'am.
It's error. Why? Tell me. Yes, you are correct. But why it will take error, students?
Data, ma'am.
Because of wrong data, isn't it? Very good.
Yeah, ma'am.
Yes, very, very good, students. So that is the concept, students. So without the validation, your designing is of no use. You can enter any data, and if the server is taking any data, whether your websites are going to make a trend in the market, no. It is what improper design. It is improper web development. So for that reason, we compulsorily need what? Validation of the data. Okay, if your form is taking this data without showing any error, it means your forms are not designed or not validated. So for this reason, we have to use a middleware script, which is called as a JavaScript. Using JavaScript, what you have to do? You have to validate this data. You have to take this text box data and compare with the original data. You have to take this text box data and compare with the original data and check whether the entered text box, for example, the name of this text box is text box number one. For example, let us take here, this is your text box one, txt box one. The other one is txt box two. Okay, so for text box one, I'm checking if the entered data is equals to alpha. Okay, if it is alpha, then what? Then only take the data. For this, what I'm checking? I'm checking if the entered data is equal to alpha. Okay, numeric. I'm using inbuilt functions. You have learned in C programming, right? You have learned in strings. If the entered digit is alphabet, if the entered digit is alphanumeric. So all the coding concepts we are going to use in the JavaScripting language. We are going to use code only. We are going to code it like C programming. And we are going to include that within the script tag. So how that parameters are passed, we will take the box number. We will take box number or we will take the box name. And then what we will do, we will pass that box name to your JS code. So that JS box value is compared into the JS. We will write the code and we will check what value you have entered in the text box one is alpha or not. What value you have entered in the text box two, whether it is what alphanumeric or not. Are you getting that? So this type of concept, students, comes into JavaScript. So what we do in this exactly JavaScript, students, we do the process of writing the code. We write the code to extract the value from every element of the form. We are going to check the values from every element of the form. We are going to check the text boxes. We are going to check radio buttons. We are going to check the selection boxes. We are going to check the values of check boxes. We are going to validate everything. We are going to check everything, in short. And then only you can go on the submit button. Otherwise, the submission is not possible. Are you getting? So this form we have learned using only HTML. Now please observe, students, if I click on submit button, what is going to happen? My data will go and it will store somewhere into the local server. Okay, see, I have given file.php. So why, what is that file.php? So see, this is my page source. Source code you can see here in the browser also, students. So in that I have done form submit is equals to, I have submitted that form. To which location? File.php. Our form tag contains of how many this one, students? Tell me, our form tag contains of form name, form action, isn't it? Huh? Yes, it contains of form name, method and action. So we are using form name, form one, method is post, action is equals to what I have taken, students? I have taken a file name. So I have told you, what is that action? Action means action indicates the name of the file where you are going to send this file after processing to the server. So I have taken file.php. This is the file. This is the you can say that the program where my processed data will go after I press to the submit button. but that is not there for your syllabus students, so we don't need to worry that now. We are going to learn the front wear and middle wear. Okay, in the next semesters we will learn the details, right? So what will happen with your data? That action is equals to file. In the sense, the file will go to this destination. Are you getting me? So it should not directly go to that destination without validation. If it is taking wrong data, what it indicates? It indicates that your process is wrong. Are you getting? So the today's introduction of JS is mainly focusing for what, students? JS is used for these concepts. We are using JavaScripts for validation to create the interactive web pages, okay, to check your data, to validate your data, to process your data, and then only the data is sent to the server. Okay, yeah. So before pressing on the submit button, when I press on submit button, what will happen? It will go to file.php. When I press on the submit button, it will go what file name you have passed to the action parameter. So I have passed this name, so it will take the value from the action parameter, and then it will go where, students? It will go to this file. But before moving to that file, what we have to do? We have to validate the data. Clear to you, students? Yes. So this is the introduction of your today's class, students. And from tomorrow onwards, we will start with the basic concepts of your JS. Okay. So this is the introduction of today's JavaScript. Okay. So tomorrow we will go for syntactic characteristics. We will learn how to write the JS code. Okay, we will learn how to write the JS code. What are the different ways of writing the JS code? We will also see how to write the coding. So basically, JS is coding only, students. It is just like C programming. We have to use all, like data types, variables. We have to use a combination of text boxes. Okay, we have to also use if statement, while statement, do statement, switch statement. We have to use array functions, everything. It is a combination of C as well as the C++. Okay, yeah. So I'm going to teach you that. Do not worry about that. Okay, students. Any queries are there for today's lecture, guys?